Good evening again. I'm Mayor Weaver, and I would right away I'd like to introduce our District 3 County Board member, John Curran, who would like to read the resolution that is being presented to Kathy this evening for all of her recognition from the County Board.
Thank you, Mayor. On behalf of Dan Cronin, Chairman of the DuPage County Board, and the rest of the DuPage County Board, it's my pleasure to be here to present this resolution to Kathy. Resolution of commendation to Kathy Marquez as 2013 Darien Citizen of the Year. Whereas DuPage County recognizes Kathy Marquez of Darien, who has selflessly devoted her time and talents to serving her community and improving the quality of life of her fellow neighbors. And whereas for the more than 20 years, Kathy has been an active member of the Darien Lions Club, where she is one of the top fundraisers for the annual Candy Day fundraiser and participates in the annual food drive, where she bags groceries for all those in need. And whereas when her sons attended Our Lady of Peace School, Kathy created and chaired the Market Day program that raised thousands of dollars for the school, as well as initiated the Our Lady of Peace Home and School Association, where she and her husband served as co-presidents and helped write the first constitution for the organization. Whereas since 2002, Kathy has been an active member of the Darien Historical Society and the Darien Women's Club, and whereas her passion for community involvement and service is evident through her volunteer work with the PADS program, the Alzheimer Research Fund, and the American Cancer Society, in addition to her previous service on Darien's first recycling committee, and whereas Kathy's generosity has truly made a positive impact on thousands of Darien and DuPage County families, earning her the honor of 2013 Darien Citizen of the Year. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, Daniel J. Cronin, Chairman of the DuPage County Board, and the members of the County Board, do hereby commend Kathy Marquez for humbly serving her community, thus prompting the distinction of the 2013 Darien Citizen of the Year.
Thank you very much. Thanks, John. I'll give you some more in a minute. Thanks, John. I'm so glad John was able to be here. He's a wonderful representative to the city of Darien, to the county board, and I really appreciate all of his support that has given to the city of Darien. Next, I'd like to present Kathy with a number of recognitions that we've received on her behalf. We've had numerous elected officials give us resolutions in your honor, and I'd like to start out with Dan Rutherford, the state treasurer of the state of Illinois, would like to present you with a resolution. Kathy, why don't you come up for that? I'm not going to read it again because it does recognize all of the other things that we've known about you for a very long time.
That's nice, thank you.
Yes, and also I'd like to present you with the resolution that the city of Darien, and I had to go on and on and on with all of the, I'm not gonna repeat this lady. I know, this lady I think has beat every citizen of the year before us with a wonderful record of accomplishments in service to the city of Darien. So
thank
let
you.
Me give you that. And also on Bill Foster, our U.S. representative, flew this flag in your honor on January 28th, at the U.S. Capitol. So we'd like to give that to you as recognition. So that is some wonderful recognition. So you can sit down, and I'll be back to you in a minute. Okay. Thank you. Now we have a special treat for all of you. We were treated at our city council meeting the same evening that we honored Kathy Marquez with a wonderful young lady who was a American Idol contestant who I don't watch American Idol, but I had many people tell me. Wonderful job she did. So I'd like to turn over the microphone to Mariah Polisi.
This feeling inside, I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. So excuse me for getting, but these things I do. See, I've forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, your eyes are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're in. A sculptor, but then again, no. Or a girl who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. Oh.
That was a little surprise for Kathy this evening. Mariah's our own American Idol. Thank you, Mariah. She didn't make it to the final cut, but as far as we're concerned, she's our American Idol. And now I'd like to introduce Jeff Marquez for the toast.
Well, unfortunately, I get to follow the American Idol singer. Mayor, you've been to these before, more times than I have. Is this where we roast her, or? You know, we kind of went into it tonight, and a couple of weeks ago when I was at the City of Darien's council meeting where they honored my mom, the thing that struck me the most was probably how many whereas I heard. It just kept going on and on. I mean, you guys have been these kind of things before. Have you heard that many whereas before? A couple months ago, you know, my parents approached me, and they asked me to say a few words tonight from the perspective of being her son. And since I didn't have any other perspective, I figured that would be pretty easy. The thing that struck me the most, listening to that proclamation tonight, is that it basically took me through my childhood. You know, we moved into Darien when I was about 10 years old, and I remember my mom driving us to school at Our Lady of Peace. I remember staying late after school there because of market days that she ran. I remember playing baseball in the Darien Youth Club. And I remember going into the sports car with teammates to see my mom running that too. I remember my mom being there for us while we were in high school at Hinsdale South. And I remember the Big Bucks raffle machine sitting in our dining room. You know, as I got older and I had kids of my own, you know, I remember going to Old Lay School for the annual Christmas tree lighting ceremony and then going downstairs for the cookies that she was down there for there too, helping serve. You know, most of us all here tonight, we all know how many things she's participated in, what she's volunteered for over the years, but what truly makes her different is the heart that she puts into it. She truly loves serving others, something I wish that someday I could actually emulate myself. She's a remarkable person, and you realize that in talking and being with her. It's something my two kids picked up on pretty quickly. They love their grandma, and she loves them. Despite all the times that she's given unto others, she's always found the time to be there and help me with my homework growing up, cook us a dinner, or tuck us in at bed at night with a kiss. She's done the same for Jake and Ella, and now they fight over who gets to spend their weekly visits and spend overnights on Mondays. You know, I don't know who nominated my mom for this year's award, but if you are here tonight, I want to say thank you, because it allowed others to see what me and my brothers have known all our lives. It's that Kathy Marquez is one of the most selfless people you will ever meet. She deeply cares for others and goes above and beyond the call of duty, whether that means as a friend, a fellow board member, a volunteer, a mother, or a grandmother. Darien is known as a nice place to live, but it's the people like my mother that have a part in that phrase truly meaning something special. So for those of you that haven't gone through all of your drinks, I ask for you to raise your drinks in a toast tonight to this year's Darien of the Year, or Darien Citizen of the Year, my mom, Kathy Marquez. Without further ado, I will turn it over to the Master of Ceremony, Mr. Joseph Marquez.
I've had an opportunity to do this a couple times. I think when Chris Sott became Citizen of the Year, Chris asked me to be MC, and a number of years ago, back in 1991, Ira Brusoff asked me, and I co-MC'd that with a gentleman by the name of Bill Sternugel. And I have to say that I planned out everything that I was going to say for those events way ahead of time. And for the last several weeks, all my friends, I go to breakfast with a group of guys on Wednesday morning, and it was, well, what are you going to say, Joe? And I said, you know, I really don't know what I'm going to say. I want this to be so perfect, and I want to say just the right things. And, you know, with Kathy, there's a deep emotional side to her winning this award, because so many of these things that she's done, you know, she's touched so many lives, and I've seen that. And I've seen the unselfish behaviors that she's used to get so much of this done. But I'd like to thank the committee. I'd like to thank Kathy Lyons and Fran and Bonnie and Gloria and Joan for their work at putting this together. Let's give them a round of applause. They did a great job. I'd like to thank all of you for taking time out of your important lives to share in this with us tonight. I also like to thank Kathy Marquez for being named this year's Citizen of the Year, because as my good friend John Galan will tell you, I've never met a microphone I haven't liked. And Kathy winning this award gives me an opportunity to do it again. So thank you, Kathy. 43 years ago, and I hate to mention that, but 43 years ago, when I was 19 years old, I was introduced to a young lady who was carrying a laundry basket up to her dormitory room. She had a rip in her sweatshirt, no makeup on, and I fell in love with her. And unfortunately, she didn't fall in love with me. I think we're very fortunate, and I tell all my good friends this, that our wives are our better halves. And I was very fortunate that after some gentle persuasion and some occasional dates and get-togethers, that Kathy reciprocated, and she found in her heart to share with me how much she loved me. And we've never been apart since then, and that was 43 years ago. And just so you know, this year will be 40 years that we've been married, so congratulations to us. You know, life is about relationships. It's the people who surround you, be they family or be they friends. The quality of those relationships are what dictate the quality of our life. We can earn a lot of money, have a big bank account, have a beautiful home, drive a nice car, but what really matters is the people that are there for you when you're in need, when you're hurting, and when you're happy. That's what it's all about. And Kathy understands that, I think, more than anybody. Just to give you an example, Jeffrey was in first grade at Our Lady of Peace. Kathy was a lunch mother, as she was so many years. Little Jonathan Droz fell down in the parking lot, and Jonathan knocked his tooth out. And Pat wasn't there for her son. And what did Kathy do? Kathy picked Jonathan up, picked up his tooth, ran to the dentist with Jonathan. Now, they couldn't save the tooth, but Jonathan was okay. And Pat called a couple weeks ago, and she says, Kathy, do you remember when you took Jonathan to the dentist and you tried to get him to save his tooth? That epitomizes who this woman is. In those relationships that I talk about, those relationships that are so critical, Kathy has formulated so many of those relationships. I look at her friendships. I look at the wonderful friendships that she has. And she has a number of you in this room tonight that she calls her friends. I look at the family that surrounds us and the love that we feel for one another. And I know that that's the way it is because this woman is like the hub. Everything revolves around her. Now, I also have to tell you that being married to Kathy is a little bit like being married to Lucy. Kathy is a real stitch sometimes to be married to. She is. She's funny. She says things that every so often we'll learn a new word and Kath tries to use it. And we always kind of laugh because all the boys sit back and say, Ma, are you sure you're using that word right? But you know, while we may laugh, we're not laughing at her, we're laughing with her because she laughs at herself. And unlike Lucy, Kathy gets everything done. She doesn't eat the chocolate off the assembly line and she doesn't fall down on the dance floor. But she has made the last 43 years of my life a lot of fun. And to echo what Jeffrey said, while she's done all these wonderful things, she's also raised three wonderful sons. I am a very fortunate man to have these three boys who are now married to these wonderful women. My son Jeffrey, his wife Christy, my son John, his wife Kelly, my son John, his wife Linda. John and Linda, Kelly and Jamie, Jeff and Christy, all right. Hey, I get to make a mistake. Now, I love my wife dearly. I think she's everything in my life. Although there's a little person that competes with her for that heart, and that's my little Ella over here. This is my granddaughter. Ella, you want to wave to everybody? No, she's hiding behind the chair. A good friend of mine, Ira Bressoff, who was our 1991 Darien Citizen of the Year, I met Ira in 1989, and Ira made a comment to me, and he said, Joe, he said, Darien is a nice community. We all benefit from Darien. And when you benefit from a community, you need to give something back to that community. I think all of us tonight who live in Darien and call Darien home know how true that is. Darien really is a wonderful community. So with a round of applause, why don't we all thank Darien for giving us the life that we have here? Can I have that round of applause? Finally, when I was 13 years old, I remember the day President Kennedy was assassinated. My grandfather, who was in his early 80s, could not understand why someone would do something like that. And so he called my father up, and my father drove out to the south side to his house to visit his mother and father to comfort them, because they were very upset about it. And on the way home, I accompanied my dad. And I was this 13-year-old boy sitting in the car still dealing with my struggles over this assassination. And I looked at my dad and I says, Dad, is the world filled with bad people like this? And he said, Joe, he says, there are people in this world who want to deprive us of the love of people like our president. He said, but you know, Joe, he says, and it is my belief, he says, that if you take care of those who are less fortunate than you, God will take care of you. That's something Kathy does every day. Kathy takes care of people who are as fortunate as her and less fortunate as her, and God takes real good care of Kathy. My congratulations, hon. You are wonderful. I love having you in my life. I thank God that you didn't listen to that roommate of yours who told you not to date me anymore. And she really did. She says, this girl told her, says, you don't want to go out with him. He's like a leech. You'll never get rid of him. And she was right. She never did. She never got rid of me. She never will. I like you to get to know Kathy from different perspectives. We're very fortunate tonight to have with us Kathy's aunt and her godmother, Mrs. Shirley Schultz. And Shirley, she's known Kathy a lot longer than I have. And she asked if she could say a few words about her niece and her godchild from a little different perspective. So, Aunt Shirley, why don't you come on up? We're not going to mention your age either, Aunt Shirley. This is another woman who has been very active, president of her Elks Club and Emblem Club, and I think it runs in the thing.
Oh, I'm Shirley, Kathy's aunt, and also her godmother. And I never fathomed quite what she did. All I remember was Market Day at Our Lady of Peace. I got that right. I've been calling it Prince of Peace. I'm sorry that her mother cannot be with us tonight to brag about her, but I'll try and do a good job of it. If you can possibly imagine that while growing up, this gal was a shy gal. She was so shy that when we were living next door to each other in apartments, when both Kathy and my daughter Linda were born, and they're 12 days apart, she was so shy that I would come into the apartment, and you can imagine how close Dolores, her mother, and I were living next to one another. She wouldn't even have enough gumption to say hello to me. And my daughter and Linda and Kathy grew up together. And when Kathy went to NIU, she met Joe. Well, she became entirely different person. She really blossomed out. You would never believe, except for knowing her today, the many things she has accomplished. I do not believe that Kathy knows the word no and rarely used it when help is needed. She really has grown up into a wonderful young lady, and you all know that by how she has touched your lives. From handling Market Day at Our Lady of Peace School to helping Joe in his alderman position in various capacities, her life, and oh, let's not forget being a grandmother too, she hardly used the word no and rarely used it when help was needed. She also helped Joe in his capacity in his alderman position and did the various necessities that they had to attend stuff and that, and she is an individual who is always being available. To Kathy and the inspiration she gives us all for the future, we truly are proud of you and your accomplishments. And we're proud you are part of our family, and good health and happiness be with you all the rest of your life. We all love you and happy you touched our lives. God bless you.
Thank you, Ann Schull. She didn't say how I changed Kathy.
No, you
said
what?
No. You can go sit down now, Ann Schull. There's a couple of women here are here tonight who like to talk about Kathy and their work with Kathy in different capacities. I'd like to introduce a member of the Darien Women's Club and a woman that Kathy's worked with a lot over the last 8 years, Cheryl Darien. Cheryl? Here she comes. And I just asked Cheryl to do this tonight, so.
Joe did ask me tonight to say a few words, and I believe this will be short. Kathy and I have worked together on the hospitality committee for Darien Women's Club for about 5 years. And Kathy is a wonderful person, but we have kind of different styles. Right, Kathy? I'm more anal, you could say. Kathy, have you called these members to bring the goodies for tonight? Oh, Cheryl, it'll get done. And it does. Somehow it comes together between her style and my style. And as Aunt Shirley, as that said, I cannot believe that Kathy has ever been shy. She's very outgoing. Prior to hospitality, she did membership. And I think brought in a few new members. And from what I know of Kathy, she is very compassionate. And we have a great time together, and I'm so glad to call her my friend.
For Kathy's also, you know, very involved in the Darien Historical Society, and a woman who's worked with Kathy quite a bit in planning our Sunday dinner, who, when I went to her table tonight and asked her if she would talk, I said, I know you'll do a great job. And she says, of course I'll do a great job. Those of you who attend Historical Society Sunday dinner know this woman. She has wonderful lines and jokes that she tells us, but she's also a wonderful person. And that is Miss Alice Brennan. Alice.
I think, thank you. I'm not sure. But I think, thank you, Joe, for including us. I actually do know that I thank him very much on behalf of the Historical Society. And can you hear me back there?
Yes.
Good, good, good. Thank you, because she is irreplaceable. She's fun. At the same time, she's working hard, but she makes it look really easy. And that's what's so tricky about her. Because you think, how can anybody be so happy and be working so hard? And she does. It's amazing. I enjoyed her personally. we all have on the board enjoyed her, and you know she'll never say no to you. And she'll even come up with a few of her own ideas of how to keep herself busy. And if she doesn't keep herself busy enough, and she finds out there's an opening in another group that they could use a hand, she's there. I know it, I've seen it, I've heard it. We love her dearly. And I want you to know that I just got off the plane coming back from Rome. I was over there. You know, you've seen this on TV, the conclave that was going on with the Roman Catholic Church at the Vatican. Well, I nominated her for Catherine I at Pope. So the next time they need one, they've got an early person. She could be the first woman. She could be many firsts. But first of all, she's the queen of Darien right now. And thank you so much for helping us all throughout this whole community, Kathy. Take care.
Thank you, Alice. Having done this so many times, we knew that people appreciated shorter programs. I want you to know that when Kathy Lyon and Fran Maslany came to the house, I answered the door. And I know Kathy and I know Fran. And I looked at them and I said, who are you here for? And they said, for Kathy. And I said, why? You want some money for the women's club or something like that? I had no idea why they were there. You think, here I am, this guy. I'm an alderman. I knew it was Citizen of the Year time, and I had no idea. And Kathy goes, who's at the door? And I said, Fran Maslany, and the girls are here. There's some girls here for you. And I hope you don't mind I refer to you as girls. Kathy came around the corner, and she kind of knew right away why they were there. I think she knew. And she started to cry. And Kathy looked at her and said, Kathy, this is your year. This is your turn. Everybody says that you're the person who gives of yourself, and you're there for everybody else. And this is your year. And I have to be honest with you and tell you that we both cried. And then she looked at me and she says, can I say no? And I said, no, I can't say no. I want to be an MC. So she didn't say no. I'm lost for words. I'm glad I've got such good one-liners here. I'm a lucky man. I have a wonderful family. And I have a woman in my life who is the best thing I ever did in my life, and that is to have her as my partner and my mate for the last 43 years. And I hope the next 43 years are as much fun as the last 43 years. Kathy, you're a wonderful person. These people here tonight are a testimony to everything that you've done. And with that, honey, I think I'll turn the microphone over to you and say congratulations.
Thank you. You can all sit down. Please sit down. I had to write it down because it's my scratch, but a secretary for 15 years, you'd think I would type, but no, I didn't. Anyone that knows me, this is not my cup of tea, this is my husband's, but... thank goodness you all are in your underwear because I don't think I could get through this otherwise. For those of you that were not at the coffee and cake reception for me, I just want to reiterate what I said. To be singled out, with so many qualified citizens in Darien,